The story of Dr. Mary Fitzbutler Waring, born in 1870, is impressive in its own right, but it really begins with her parents, Father Henry Fitzbutler and Mother Sari McCurdy. Father Henry was the first African-American graduate of the Detroit Medical College and the University of Michigan School of Medicine in 1872. Mother Sari would become the first African-American woman to earn her medical degree in Kentucky, where the Fitzbutler family relocated. Henry would serve as the first and only African-American doctor to thousands of Black Louisvillians. Sarah Fitzbutler became a physician after she raised the couple's 6 children. Henry would not only open the only medical school in Louisville to accept African-American students, he also was a crusading editor with his Ohio Falls Express newspaper, arguing for equal rights and equal education. Meanwhile, Sarah earned a reputation as an outstanding doctor and supervised the nursing program at the Louisville National Medical College. Daughter Mary Fitzbutler, she would be Waring after marrying, followed in her parents' footsteps. She taught school and was a student at the Louisville Medical School and later graduated from the National Medical College of Chicago, a city that would become her base for work and community building. Taking a page from the family newspapers advocating for community and equality, Mary Fitzbutler was active in the Red Cross during World War I, organizing classes for African American nurses, and she became a force in women's organizations, attending the International Conference of Women in Norway in 1920. She also rose through the ranks until she was elected president of the National Association of Colored Women. While president, she petitioned another president, Franklin Roosevelt, to desegregate passenger cars on trains. Another of her initiatives was to destroy toy guns. She wrote newspaper columns, as her father did, and corresponded with W.E.B. Du Bois about Pan-Africanism. She died in 1958, but what a family legacy lives on.